This is Scott Freck, Executive Director of the Eugene Symphony. In an interview recorded at public radio station KLCC in downtown Eugene, I had a chance to talk with Searmi Park, who is the soloist for our performance of Barber's Violin Concerto on Thursday, November 13th. Besides being our soloist this month, Searmi is also the concertmaster of the Eugene Symphony, which means most of the time she sits in the first chair of the first violin section. This is her first opportunity, since her appointment in 2013, to step into the soloist spotlight. I asked her what it will be like to stand in front of the orchestra rather than lead her section from her chair.
I'm pretty excited about it. I never get to see my colleagues' faces, especially the violinists who sit behind me. And the Barber Violin Concerto has a lot of interaction. The solos are passed within all the sections. The woodwind players get a lot. The brass, the trumpet, and the horns have a lot of the solo as well. And to be able to play facing my first violin colleagues will be a lot of fun.
So you get to finally see what they look like.
That's right. I get to see their faces while they're playing.
And they get to see something beside the back of your head.
Exactly. They get to see my face, too. So
nice. So, Searmi, where and when was the first time you played a concerto as the soloist in front of an orchestra? What was the piece, and how do you feel about that piece now?
My first big concerto, I actually was the concertmaster at UCLA, and I was a freshman. And at the end of the season, I got to stand up and play the Sibelius Violin Concerto, which was a big deal for me. And it was a lot of fun. And I learned a lot from that experience. And my teacher also planned it so that I had several big concertos to play in a row. So the following year, I played the Brahms Violin Concerto, and the year after that I played the Beethoven Violin Concerto, so I learned a lot in a very short time.
It's a pretty good big three to start with.
That's right.
Wow. So this is your first time, however, playing the Barber Violin Concerto, which you're going to be playing with us. How do you start to prepare for a new piece like that?
The Barber I had never studied. I hadn't played it with orchestra, obviously, but I never studied it either in school. So I started just slowly practicing it this past March of this year, not listening to any recordings. I wasn't looking at any scores. I was just trying to get my part really, really clean and start to get the last movement under my fingers, which needs to happen ahead of time. It's a very, very difficult movement. And so I started doing that early on.
Okay, and then where does it go from there?
And then from there, I had some other big concerts, so I took a little time off from the concerto early in the summer, and I started again to really, really practice it, I would say middle, late summer. And then I started to listen to recordings of other violinists playing it, like Hilary Hahn and Gil Shaham and Isaac Stern. Those are a few of my favorites. And then started to look at the score and try to read a little bit about what was going on in Barber's life when he wrote the concerto.
So what are you taking away from these other performances, Hilary or Gil? What are you hearing and going, oh, I like that, or oh boy, I don't like that?
Oh, there's a lot that I like of those three that I mentioned. Isaac Stern has this old world way of playing his sound, and his overall concept of the concerto I really agree with, and that sits well with me. Hilary Hahn is a great example of technical perfection. She plays so cleanly and with such a perfect sound all the time. And her last movement, I think, is 200 plus metronome marking for the quarter note. It is unbelievably fast. And so just to have that as a goal, of course, I won't be able to play it that fast, but is actually very inspiring. And Gil Shaham, I just love the emotional way that he plays. And he plays with such joy that for me, I get a lot from listening to him play.
So tell us a few things to be listening for. It starts with such an extraordinary opening. I can't think of another concerto quite like it. I guess for me, the closest would be the Tchaikovsky Piano Concerto, which has the big chords and then launches immediately into the best melody the whole piece has. This one starts with the violin from the get-go with the big theme, and we're off to the races already.
Yes, I actually like that because I think the usual wait time where the soloist is standing there waiting while is very nerve-wracking. So for me to just be able to start with the big chord in the beginning is very nice. And the way that Barber writes such a long phrase, and within that long phrase there are many ups and downs, and just when you think he's going to end the phrase, he's actually starting a new one, and I think that's the challenge, but also the reward of working on a concerto like this.
Can we hear a little bit of the beginning of the first movement?
Yes.
Thank you.
Nice, nice. Well, speaking of gorgeous, I think the second movement is one of the most beautiful pieces of music ever written in America. It's just so perfect. Can we hear just a little bit of that?
Yeah.
And of course, the third movement of this piece is kind of famous for being an absolute fireball. It's perpetual motion. The violinist hardly ever stops, I mean, even for a half a second. And I know it's notoriously difficult. And I'm going to put you on the spot and ask you to play just a little bit of the beginning of the third
sure.
movement. So I know you'll probably be breathless, but the audience will be breathless too, because it's like that for 4.5 minutes of fury and then this incredible ending. And of course, we don't want to play that because we don't want to give away the end. So
right.
Searmi, thank you so much for playing for us. And we look forward to hearing you play Barbara's Violin Concerto on Thursday, November 13th. Look forward
thank
to
you.
It.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, thanks. Violinist Searmi Park talking about and playing the Violin Concerto by Samuel Barber, which she'll perform with the Eugene Symphony on Thursday, November 13th at the Holt Center. More information can be found at eugenesymphony.org. This interview was recorded at public radio station KLCC in downtown Eugene. I'm Scott Freck, Executive Director of the Eugene Symphony, and thanks for listening.